ask me why it is I don't write songs anymore about the Rocky Mountains, about the preservation of wildlife, about freedom and the outdoors. Well, I still do. I don't know why they've missed them. But, you know, life in the Rocky Mountains, while it is different, it's really the same as life everywhere on the planet. We must take care of our dear Mother Earth. And I try to put that in the songs that I write, and the songs that I sing, everywhere that I sing around the world. Now, here's a couple of songs, Dancing with the Mountains and Wild Montana Skies. Dancing with the Mountains was written at Lake Powell on a week that I spent there fasting in the spring, which I try to do every year. And I'd thought about all the dancing craze that was going on a few years ago and this whole thing about disco dancing and disco music. And this was my contribution to that kind of sound, although the kind of dancing that I'm most familiar with, dancing with the mountains on skis, dancing in the air with a plane that I fly, this is what I like.
Everybody's got the dancing fever. Everybody loves to rock and roll. Play it loud, it's baby, play it get faster. Funky music's gonna stretch your soul. Just relax and rest, and take it. Don't you be afraid to lose control. If your heart is found some empty spaces, dancing's just a thing to make you whole. I am one who dances with the mountains. I am one who dances with the wind. Oh, oh, oh. I am one who dances on the ocean. Yeah, yeah. My partner's more in pieces, more than lightning. Were you there the day the earth stood still? Did you see the faints and the fighting? Did you hear the prophet tell his tale? Oh, we are one. We're dancing with the mountains. Yeah, yeah. We are one. We're singing with the
Wild Montana Skies was written about some friends up in Montana. I had the great pleasure of singing with Emmylou Harris on this song. I think you really like the way this lady sings. I know I do.
He was born in the Bitterroot Valley in the early morning rain. Wild geese over the water, heading north and home again. Bringing a warm wind from the south, bringing the first taste of the spring. His mother took him to her breast, softly she did sing. Oh, Montana, give his child a home. Give him the love of a good family and a woman of his own. Give him a fire in his heart, give him a light in his eyes. Give him the wild wind for a brother and the wild Montana skies. His mother died that summer and he never learned to cry. He never knew his father, and he never did ask why. And he never knew the answers that would make an easy way. But he learned to know the wilderness and to be a man that way. His mother's brother took him into his family and his home. Gave him a hand that he could lean on, and strength to call home. And he learned to be a farmer, and he learned to love the land. And he learned to read. lessons I learned to make a stand. Oh, Montana, give this guy a home. Give him a love of a good family and a woman of his own. Give him a fire in his heart. Give him a light in his eyes. Give him the wild wind for a brother in the wild of Montana skies. On the eve of his 21st birthday, he set out on his own. He was 30 years in running, but he found his way back home. Ride a storm across the mountains and lived him in his heart. Said he came to turn the pages and make a brand new start. Now another cold, cold green time he was gone. Some say he was a martyr, some say he was a god. There was something in the city that he said he couldn't breathe. There was something in the country that he said he couldn't leave. Oh, Montana, give this guy a home. Give him the love of a good family, a woman of his own. Give him a fire in his heart. Give him a light in his eyes. Give him a wild wind for a brother in the wild Montana sky. Now some say he's crazy, some are glad he's gone. Some of us will miss him, we'll try to carry on. Giving a voice to the forest, giving a voice to the dark. Giving a voice to the wilderness, in the land that he lived on. Oh, Montana, give this child a home. Give him a love, a good family, and a woman of his own. Give him a fire in his heart, give him a light in his eyes. Give him the wild wind for a brother, and the wild Montana skies. Oh, Montana, give this child a home. Give him a love of a good family and a woman of his own. Give him a fire in his heart. Give him a light in his eyes. Give him the wild wind for a brother in the wild Montana skies.
As you listen to this, I will have just returned from my first performing trip to Russia. As I record this, we are in the midst of the preparations for these concerts. You know, I've never been more excited about anything in my life. Although we have no cultural exchange between the United States and Russia, both governments have been very, very gracious and helpful in this venture, which is really the first private enterprise of its kind in the Soviet Union. This is not a political visit. I was invited by the Composers Union to sing for the composers and musicians and other singers of the Soviet Union, to visit their country, to get to know their people. I can't tell you how proud I am to have this opportunity to share my music with the people of the Soviet Union.
When you ask how I've been here without you, I like to say I've been fine. And I do. But we both know the truth is hard to come by. And if I told the truth, that's not quite true. Some days a diamond, some days a stone. Sometimes the hard times won't leave me alone. Sometimes a cold wind blows a chill in my bones. Some days a diamond, some days a stone. In my mirror, more and more is a stranger to me. More and more I can see there's a danger in becoming what I never thought I'd be. Some days a diamond, some days a stone, sometimes a heart. Some days a diamond, some days a stone. Some days a diamond, some days a stone, and sometimes a hard time.
It was the night before Christmas when all through the house not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. The children were nestled all snug in their beds.
Up until now, I guess we haven't spoken really a great deal about the holidays. You know, there's such a beautiful glow that goes through this season of the year, a glow that lights the human spirit, no matter what its pain or suffering. I guess the holidays, this time of spirit and emotion and peace and goodwill, brings out the innocence and the joy of the child in all of us. During the holidays, we're filled with love for one another and a special love for children.
There are children raised in sorrow on a scorched and barren plain. There are children raised beneath the golden sun. There are children of the water, children of the sand, and they cry out through the universe, their voices raised as one. I want to live, I want to grow, I want to see, I want to know, I want to share what I can give, I want to be, I want to live.
But you know, there are places in the world where the joy of the holiday season will never penetrate. In Ethiopia, in Kenya, Mozambique, and scores of other places in Africa, the joys of the holiday season are dulled and blunted by famine and hunger. Real famine, people actually dying before your very eyes. I've seen it. And having seen it, I'm more determined than ever to help eradicate it from the realm of human experience, not only for children, but for all human beings. As you may know, I've been a very vocal spokesman for UNICEF. I'm also one of the founders and serve on the board of directors of the Hunger Project, and I'm working very closely with other hunger organizations around the world. It is our purpose to put an end not only to the crisis of famine, but to the persistence of hunger, and to see that everyone on this globe is fed. Some think it sounds impossible, but it is doable. It has been proven. It has been documented. I think you'll be hearing a lot more about all of this in 1985, and a lot more of this song. It was written as the cry, as a plea of the children of the world. In fact, when I wrote it, what I was trying to say is what I hear in the first cry of every newborn baby. It says, I want to live.
dressed in holiday style. In the air there's a feeling of Christmas. Children laughing, people passing, meeting smile after smile, and on every street corner you
as a final word on this sacred and wonderfully touching time of year, I want to thank you for all the love and the affection that you've showered on me and my family. If the simple songs that I write have meaning for you, if they help you express the feelings you have for the ones that you love, my mission in life is complete. Music is a universal language, and its gift, like the gift that we celebrate during this season, is one that can bring us all closer together and help us to achieve the dream of all ages, the dream of peace on earth and goodwill among humankind. Merry Christmas, everyone, and Happy New Year. God bless you all. I'll see you in 85.
Christmas Day.